हेलो एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू डूइंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मेरी क्रिसमस, हैप्पी हॉलीडेज। आई होप एवरीवन इज हैविंग हॉलीडे, या करेक्ट? इवन यस्टरडे वी टू हैड हॉलीडे, आई मीन नॉट वी इन द सेंस इन द यूट्यूब वी हैड हॉलीडे, राइट? यस। चतुर्या, श्रेयंश, ओ एक्समस गिफ्ट, यू शुड बी गिफ्टिंग मी। आकाश, ज्ञानी, रेकन, चतुर्या, या आकाश, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई हैव ऑनलाइन क्लास, ओ ओके, अर्चना हैज ऑनलाइन क्लास, अगर्शा। सो लेट्स गेट क्विकली स्टार्टेड विद द इम्पॉर्टेंट मोस्ट आस्ट क्वेश्चंस ऑफ डाइवर्सिटी लिविंग चैप्टर, डाइवर्सिटी इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स चैप्टर, राइट? नाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर रेफर्ड एज डाइवर्सिटी इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैज बीन डिलीटेड फ्रॉम CBSE 9th, yes. So for the final exams of the class 9th standard, this particular chapter hasn't been included. But for all the competitive exams, this particular chapter is very important and a lot of questions you can expect from this particular chapter. Yes, 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 yes. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas. Happy New Year at the same time. New Year is going to come very soon, right? Okay, yes. Students, anyone is new to my class? Anyone is new to my class? Christmas vacation in online, okay Chaturya, yeah, Akash is new, Sunita, okay, Mokshit neat, so junior doctor trailer is also going to come up very soon, it's starting on January 1st, you should gift us, we are future doctor. Yes students, if you are new to the class, let me introduce myself very quickly, and I could see one of the student saying me ma'am. So that is Madhav Aditya Sahu is a newcomer for the class. So I'm Vindhya Rao, will be taking up biology in this particular channel. Let's crack foundation or NTSC. I have done my master's in biochemistry, bachelor's in biochemistry, botany, zoology. Qualified CSET exam, mentored more than 10,000 students for various exams like NTSC, NEET, IOQ, JS, CBSE 9, CBSE 10th and many more exams. Yes. And more than anything and everything, I'm here to make you fall in love with the subject biology, because if you love the subject, you will be able to understand it. And if you are able to understand it, you are able to crack any of the questions. You will be curing all the diseases in the world. That's so great. Yes, Omkar Harish is new, it seems. Yes, hello. So students, if you haven't taken the subscription yet, and if you are the serious aspirants of the NEET, if you really want to become doctor, let me suggest you something. You can take directly the NEET category subscription. Now in this particular category referred as NEET UG, you will be able to study biology, physics, chemistry. That is the syllabus of that is the subjects of the NEET, and all the syllabus of the NEET is covered in this particular category. And while going for the subscription, go either for 1 year or 2 year subscription, right? And even iconic subscription is also available. And while taking the subscription, for the discount of 10%, also for the guidance of various exams, you can use my code VRLIVE. And if in case, along with the preparation of the NEET exam, if you want to prepare for, let's say, JEE, CBSE 9, CBSE 10th, NTSC, IOQ, JS, you can directly take up the subscription of Foundation NTSC Olympiad, right? So in this particular category subscription, you will be able to cover the syllabus of 9th and 10th. At the same time, you will be also able to prepare for JEE, NEET, NTSC, IOQ, JS and many more exams. And over here as well, while taking the subscription, go for either 1 year or 2 year, because the syllabus is going to get covered in either 1 year or 2 year subscription. And you know what you should be doing while taking the subscription? The code should be VRLIVE, right? For the discount and definitely for the notes as well as for the guidance for the various exams. So let's get started quickly. The very first question. Yes. Which one is a true fish? Yeah, students, answer the question. Answer the question quickly. Which one is a true fish? Okay, okay. Some of you are saying silverfish, some of you are saying dogfish, some of you, anyone, jellyfish, starfish? Yes, mixture of answers students you are giving. So yes, of course, most of you have given the absolutely right answer. Let me call your name, whoever have given the right answer. Agarsha, Madhav, Aditya is wrong, and Chaturya, Yes. So these many students, even Komal, okay, have given the right answer. Hi, Nisha. That is dogfish. Can you tell me another name for this dogfish? Yeah. Can you tell me another name for this dogfish? Does this bark like dog, students? Bow-wow. Huh? Inside the sea. Even if they bark, are we able to hear it? What is this dogfish? Why it has been referred as dogfish? Tell me. NTSC Maharashtra May 152 May hoga kya? What are you? Are you asking about the cutoff? Not has been released yet. Yes, my smart students even know the scientific name. Agarsha knows the scientific name, Scoliodon. Absolutely right, Agastya. Even Stuti, sorry, Agarsha, not Agastya, sorry. Yes, Stuti also said Scoliodon. Simpler, simple name for the student, simple name for the dogfish. Yeah, Scoliodon, shark, right? Now, why the name this? Why the name dogfish? Why not catfish? Catfish also is there, okay? Catfish is also existing, which is the real fish, which is a true fish. But why the name dogfish? Because they appear like a dog, they look like a dog. And why the name catfish? Even catfish also looks like a cat, only a little bit. So that's why the name catfish, dogfish, which are the true fish. Whereas jellyfish belongs to the phylum Cnidaria. Right? Starfish belongs to the phylum Echinodermata. Echinodermata. Dogfish belongs to the phylum Chordata and the class Pisces. That is of fishes only. Okay, they are the cartilaginous fishes. Now, what is this silver fish? Huh? What is the silver fish? Hello, Reva. Another name is Hus. I have NTSC stage one tomorrow. All the best, Archana, Tamil Nadu, right? Yeah, all the best. Yeah. I'm good, Reva. What is the silver fish, students? It is not Pisces. Silver fish is. Yeah, cat and dog fish, correct. That's so cute, Komal. So silver fish is actually an insect. If in case if you do not open your books for some 6 months, after 6 months there is an insect which is going to tell hi to you when you open the textbook or when you open the book that you haven't opened for 6 months, and that particular insect is actually looks like a fish, because it is going to go like this, and they will be having silver, silvery coat. So that's why the name of that particular insect is silver fish. Okay, got it? So answer is dogfish. Scoliodon, shark, one and the same they all are. Yes, a silver fish is a small, primitive, wingless insect in the order of, oh my God. Enough, enough. I know it is a Google answer. Next question: which among the following is exclusively marine? Swati, what are you trying to ask? Are you asking regarding the cutoff marks? Cutoff marks haven't been released yet. Don't spam here. Yeah. Answer. Answer, students. Which among the following is exclusively marine? Yeah. Porifera, Echinodermata, Mollusca, Pisces. Pisces, okay. Exclusively marine. Do you understand when I say exclusively marine? Huh? D A B C D E F G. Yeah. Enough. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. Stop giving the random answers. Wrong. Most of you were wrong. Okay, let me first call the students whoever have given the right name. Swati, Agarsha, Aditya, Vandana, and that's it as of now. Later students have given the answers, yes. So answer is, students, Echinodermata, because they are exclusively marine. What is marine? The organisms that is living in the ocean, sea, basically in the salt water, are referred as marine, right? So echinoderms, all of them, they live in the marine condition. What about porifera? Poriferans are marine as well as freshwater. So if you consider spongilla, Some of the porifers referred as spongilla, bath sponges, they live in fresh water. Mollusca. Mollusca, freshwater molluscans we eat, some of you eat, right? So they live in both. Pisces, Pisces students, dogfish is marine, shark is marine, yes? So they live in the salt water usually, ocean or sea. Freshwater fishes can be katla, rohu, yeah? Simple it was. Yeah, Komal also give the answer later, yeah, Komal. So let's move for the next question. That's why my answer is wrong. Yes, Chaturyam. Next question. Elephantiasis is caused by. Elephantiasis is caused by. Visceraria, pinworm, planarians, liver fluke. Yeah. Hi, filter key. Now what to do? Everyone have given the right answer. So what to do? Huh? What to do, students? Everyone know the answer. Elephantiasis. What is another name for elephantiasis? Filariasis. Why the name elephantiasis? The reason is the person who is suffering from this filariasis, that is caused by Visceraria bancrofti, Visceraria malai, are able to show swelling in their limbs, especially in the legs and in the genitalia. Okay, so the limbs, especially the legs and the genital part of the individual, whoever suffered by the filariasis, they will be able to show very fat limbs. Just like how elephant has very fat limbs, in the same way they are also able to show such sort of limbs. So that's why the name of the disease is itself filariasis, I mean elephantiasis. Okay, simple it is once again. Elephant like fat like, yes, correct. Visceraria bancrofti, Visceraria malai are the organism which are able to show elephantiasis. Yes. Next question. Also keep liking the video, students. Yeah. Which one of the following, okay, which one is the most striking or common character of the vertebrates? Are we vertebrates or invertebrates? Am I vertebrate or invertebrate? Huh? Students, are you vertebrates or invertebrates? Which one of the following is most striking or common character of the vertebrate? Yeah, we are vertebrates, right? Vertebral column we have. I give a biggest hint basically. So yes, all of you have given the right answer, absolutely right answer. Answer is going to be A, because presence of the notochord, presence of the dorsal nerve cord, presence of the pharyngeal gill slits, right? So these are the, and along with this presence of post anal tail, there are four characters which will be the characteristic feature of the chordata. But the question here is about vertebrata. So answer is going to be, students, answer is going to be notochord. Now, why exactly notochord, ma'am? Because in the vertebrates, we are vertebrates, but we aren't able to see notochord. Are you able to, do we have notochord? Actually, we don't have notochord. We have modified notochord, and this modified notochord is going to become vertebral column. What happened, Utkarsh? What is so funny? Huh? We don't have notochord, but the notochord got modified in us for vertebral column production. Okay, so we may not have notochord, but we have no modified form of it. So the most correct answer is going to be notochord, right? And why other options are wrong? Because it is also present in non-chordates as well. Triploblastic condition, gill pouches, coelom, these all are found even in the non-chordates. Right, next question. Pteridophytes do not have pteridophyte. Yes, pteris, example, Dryopteris is an example, Equisetum is an example. Pteridophytes do not have which among the following? The question is from the kingdom Plantae. Yeah, only found in embryo. Ventral heart, yes, of course, we have ventral heart. Yeah, answer, students, you know, you have an interesting fact. We will be discussing some of the interesting fact in between of the class. Aren't you excited? One of the interesting fact we will be discussing. Yes, definitely. Pteridophytes won't be having flowers, right? They are not flowering plants. Pteridophytes will be having vascular tissue. They will be having root, shoot, leaves and everything, right? Simple. Next question we'll go for. Amphibians do not have the following. Three-chambered heart, gills of the lungs, scales, mucus gland. Yes? Excited, Komal? Okay. Yeah. Amphibians do not have the following. Which among the following is absent in the amphibians is a question. Yes, yes, yes. Filterki, Vandana, Ramchandran, Chakali. Others, what about others? Anyone, any other answers? Vandana, Chaturya. So answer is definitely, students, answer is going to be C only. Where do you get to see presence of scales? Huh? Where do you get to see presence of scales? Scales are present in which class of the chordates or which class of the vertebrates? What is gills of lungs, ma'am? Actually, it should have been gills or lungs. Okay. Yeah. Gills or lungs. Always excited to yes. Reptiles. Absolutely. Komal, Madhav. Chaturya. Okay. Yeah, that's true. Even in the case of Pisces, you are able to see scales. Okay. Yeah. So answer is definitely going to be scales are not found in the amphibians. They have got the moist skin. They show the respiration process by the skin, by the gills or by the lungs. Yes. Next question, students. Next question. Corals. What is this corals? Huh? Corals are. Yes. What are corals? Corals are porifers attached to some solid support. Cnidarians that are solitary living. Porifers present at the seabed. Cnidaria that live in colonies. Answer quickly. Quickly. Yes, it is helpful even for IOQJS because I have given the question which is most asked or it is going to get asked in different exams. C, everyone is C. Tukka Zindabad, C. Right, students? Some of you are like D. C. Confused between A and okay. Okay. First of all, don't say that you are confused between A and B or whatever. You are confused between porifera and cnidarians. Right. You know how I remember colorful. What is colorful? What is colorful, students? Jassi Razia. Now, C for coral, C for cnidaria. That's how I remember. Yeah. So corals are nothing but cnidarians that live in the colonies. Answer is going to be D. Komal had given the right answer. Yes. Even Purnima had given the right answer. Kiran Bala Tripathi had given the right answer. So that's it. Rest all of you give the wrong answer, students. Okay. Yes. So students, they are cnidarians which is going to live in the colonies. Example for the corals. Brain corals. Right. They actually look like brain. Yes. Next question. Okay. When you two give the answer. Now, filter key. Next question. Who introduced the system of systematic nomenclature of organisms? Basically, binomial nomenclature. Who had given binomial nomenclature? Students. Huh? Student gave the binomial nomenclature. Yeah. Robert Whittaker, Carolus Linnaeus, Robert Hooke, Ernst Haeckel. Yes. Mama B. Okay. तो अगर्षा, ऋषभ, किरण बाला, जेसी, फिल्टकी, शुभांग, कोमल हैड गिवन द राइट आंसर एज बी. लेट्स मूव द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन क्विकली. यस, केरलोसिनेस गिव द नॉमेनक्लेचर, बायनोमियल नॉमेनक्लेचर. Skeleton is made of entirely, I mean, skeleton is made entirely of cartilage in which among the following? Yes, shark, tuna, rohu, none of the above. So, which among the following, in which among the following you are able to see skeleton is made of cartilage is the question. हाँ, just before some time, मैम ने मेरा नाम ले लिया. हाँ पूर्णिमा, what is there in that? If you answer the question, I'll be calling your name. And students are randomly giving the answer. Huh? Random. Students, didn't we discuss just before some time? Didn't we discuss about cartilaginous fishes? Huh? Don't you remember? Just before some time? What is this? What is this, students? हाँ मोहित, टेल मी व्हाट आंसर इज गोइंग टू बी. स्टूडेंट, शार्क, दे आर द कार्टिलेजिनस फिशेस. डॉग फिश, स्कॉलियोडॉन, राइट? सो दे आर मेड अप ऑफ कार्टिलेज, रेस्ट ऑल आर बोनी फिश. ओके, बोनी फिश, बोनी फिश. तो रोहू यू नो, राइट? लेबिया रोहिता, रोहू, काटला, दे ऑल आर बोनी फिश. Whereas, what is tuna? What is tuna? What is tuna? Is tuna is a cartilage fish? Tuna, salmon, carp, rohu, katla, they all are bony fish. They are very famous in Japan. Tuna is quite famous in Japan. Okay, next question. Oh, it's not visible that much. ये biological name है बोनी. Yes, next. Two kingdom system classification was given by Linnaeus, Haeckel, Copeland, Whittaker. Two kingdom system classification, students. Two kingdom system classification. We have studied in the diversity chapter. Two kingdom, three kingdom, four kingdom, five kingdom, six kingdom system classification. Hello, Sahil. So who is the one who had given two kingdom system classification? Answer the question. Ma'am, मैंने ए बोला था. हाँ पूर्णिमा. Okay. Yes. So let me call your name very quickly. Rishabh Gupta. Kiran Bala. Vandana. Archana. Madhav, Chaturya have given the right answer. Students, Linnaeus had given two kingdom system classification, right? Whittaker had given four kingdom system classification. What about Copeland? What about Copeland and Haeckel? Who gave three kingdom, students? Who gave four kingdom? You should be knowing. If I tell that the answer is I'm gonna, you know, it is like, you know, I'm going to give the answer for the coming question, so I won't be talking about it. Okay, yeah, next question. One of the following is not a any lid. Archit, if you are in a plus, why aren't you able to see my courses? Huh? My new course is going to start from January, and one of the courses have just started for IOQJS. Archit Agarwal, talk to me. Which plus subscription are you talking about? Are you there in the foundation and NTSC Olympiad subscription classes? Have you taken the plus? Have you seen me? It is your responsibility to see the course. I cannot give cell phone and yes, Archit, watch my class. I cannot do that, right? I can maximum share in the classes about my courses. I keep saying the dates as well. Also, I can share about my courses in the official Telegram channel that I have done already. If you are not there in the Telegram channels, if you are not trying to connect an educator, what I can do? Huh? Don't simply you know, talk whatever gets to your mind. Before saying something, think and talk. So many courses I'm taking in a month. One of the following is not an NLEED is a question. Niris, Earthworm, leech, urchins. Very easy question. So answer is going to be C. Nereus, earthworm, leech. They all are anlidans. Now, what is this urchin? Huh? Archana, can you tell me what is urchin? What is urchin? Archana, are you here? No, Archana and Archin, the name rhymes. So just asking, what is urchin? Like under which phylum you are able to see sea urchin? Yes. Games Gamp, I'm gonna block you. Okay. Bye bye. Okay, you yourself are deleted. Great. Spike ball like thing. Oh yes, definitely it is echinoderms. Correct. So Agarsha, Komal, basically Madhav, Aditya, all of you have given the right answer. They belong to the phylum Echinodermata, sea urchin. They have got definitely they'll be having a spine-like structure all over their body part. Okay. Next question. Real organs are absent in. Real organs are absent in Mollusca, Coelenterata, Arthropoda, Echinodermata. Real organs are absent in. Answer quickly. Mollusca, Coelenterata, Arthropoda, Echinodermata. Hello, Shivam. Real organs. Don't give the wrong answer. Simply don't come and don't give the wrong answer. Think before giving the answer. Haven't I taught you diversity in living organisms? Huh? Real organs. Okay, tell me. Since students are randomly giving the answer, tell me what organ you are able to find in the cylinder. Basically, nobody have given the right answer. No one gave the right answer, students. Nobody gave the right answer. Very disappointing. Very disappointing. Tell me which organ you are able to see in the cylinderate? Huh? Which organ you are able to see in the cylinderate? Tell me. Now don't say Archana, fix sir. When I was asking, nobody's answering. Now B fix, A fix. Okay, Madhav gave. I'm actually searching for Madhav's answer. No, Madhav, not able to see it in the live chat. So, students, answer is Cnidaria, also referred as Coelenterata. Now, what are these Coelenterata and Cnidaria? One and the same basically. They have got tissue level of body organization. Tissue level of body organization, which means maximum they can form tissues. They can't form any organs. Okay. Satyarth, I am not able to see the answer in the live chat. Why should I lie? Huh? Now listen to me. Coelenterates won't be having any organ system because maximum they can form tissue. So real organs are absent in the Coelenterates, whereas Mollusca, Arthropoda, Echinodermata, they have got organs as well as organ system. Okay, they have got organ system level of body organization, and even Porifera. Porifera are able to show cellular level of body organization, so they too don't have real organs. Next question. Hard calcium carbonate structures are used as skeleton by. Answer. Answer, students, answer quickly. Hard calcium carbonate structures are used as skeleton by Echinodermata, Protocordata, Arthropoda, Nematoda. कल मैंने पहली बार इंस्टाग्राम पर आपके फैमिली की फोटो देख ली है. वेरी नाइस. बट मैम इज योर फादर फार्मर बाय प्रोफेशन. आई एम जस्ट आस्किंग. यस, ही इज अ फार्मर ऑल्सो एट द सेम टाइम ही इज अ टीचर. ओके शिवम. He is a farmer, he is a teacher. Ma'am, love you beta बोल दीजिए please. Love you beta. Happy? Yeah, students, answer. A, B, C, D. Mixture of answers. Yeah. What is this? What is this, students? Let me call your name, whoever have given the right answer. That is Vandana. Divyanshi is new to the class, is it Divyanshi? And no, nobody else. Nematodes lag raha hai. Anand ja, that's it. Yes, Shivam finally gave the answer. So answer is going to be students Echinodermata. Protocordata, they have got the skeleton system that you're able to find in the protocordata are made up of either cartilage or bone. Okay. Whereas arthropoda, they have got exoskeleton, which is made up of chitin. And in the case of nematoda, you are not able to see nematoda are nothing but the roundworms. We aren't able to see any skeleton system or as such, right? Whereas in the case of Echinodermata, they have got endoskeleton, which are actually made up of calcium carbonate, CaCO3. Thank you so much for all of your compliments, students, regarding my teaching and everything. So if I teach well, if I'm a good teacher, I also expect something from you, that is some good results, okay, in some exams. Okay, next question. Well-defined, ha, little bit late, Chaturya. Okay, yeah. So if I'm a good teacher, I want you to be little good student. Okay. So how to become a good student? Definitely, even if you get bad marks in some exams, I won't judge you. But in some, at least in some exam, like crack it and just show me. Like, we'll have interview. I'm actually waiting for such things. Okay. So well-defined nucleus is absent in easy question, students. Easy question. Radhe, Radhe, Amisha. Yeah, well-defined nucleus is absent in, huh? Blue-green algae, diatoms, Sabir Zafar, what Vinod? Don't send all those things. Algae yeast. Quickly answer, students. Yeah, yes. So let me call your name quickly. Whoever have given the right answer, because we don't have time to waste. So Satyarth. Shlok, Gautam, Himanshi, Vandana, Madhav, and Chaturya have given the right answer. Amisha, Muskan, that's it, right? Yes. So answer is going to be students A. A, that is blue-green algae are nothing but cyanobacteria they are. So bacteria do not have got nucleus, they have got nucleoid, whereas diatoms are unicellular algae. So algae can be unicellular as well as multicellular. Yeast is again, it is either unicellular or multicellular, but it has got nucleus. Next question. Not question actually, an interesting fact. Can you guess what is this, students? Can you guess what is this, anyone? This particular cuboid-like structure. How does this look like for everyone? Tell me. Huh? What is this? Tell me quickly. Quickly. How to buy NCERT full course? Okay, you just want the classes for NCERT. Either you can take the subscription of CBSE 9th or 10th, whichever class you are in. Okay, it's a clay, it's a coal, it's a melody, chocolate, camphor, cake or chocolate is the majority of you giving the answers as brownie. Cake, chocolate, melody, candy, lag raha hai. Yes. So students, you guys are wrong. First of all, it is a poop. Excreta. It is an excreta of the organism, yeah, called as wombat. Wombats. Okay. Yes, it is a potty. It is the poop, or you can call them as excreta or anything like that, right? So why this particular shape, ma'am? Like, okay, we agree it is a poop, it is excreta, or it is like potty. Okay, but why the shape is square, like cuboid, right? And that way it looks like a chocolate, like cake, brownie, everything, right? Now let me tell you who holds it in hands. You knew this organism. Okay, so the organism's name is wombat. Okay, so they literally excrete cuboid shaped poop. Yes, even though their anus is circular, even though they have got a intestine which is cylindrical, they are excreting the excreta, or I can say the Yes, the defecated, the fecal matter is going to be in the cuboidal shape. Now, why? What is the reason? What is the reason for this is they make boundaries out of their poop. Yes. So basically, biologists and engineers teamed up to solve the mystery of this wombat's cube-shaped poop. And the mystery is not a mystery anymore. The reason is like why exactly they make such type of cuboid, shaped poop is they have got the dry fecal matter. Okay, so the poop cubes are formed in the final section of the wombat intestine when they are pretty dry and where the intestinal walls have varying degree of stressness. So cause of the pressure, the moles combats wombat's poop into their characteristic shape of cuboid. So basically, cause of the dryness. As well as cause of the pressure that has been created while they are defecating, it is going to form proper cuboid-like shape. Okay, this is sort of, ma'am, what is this sort of fact? Like, I know some of you won't like it. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Intestinal, sh no. Intestine is normal only. Okay, so we will be discussing some of the interesting facts like this in upcoming classes as well. So let's move for the next question. Meena and Han. Any Meena here? Any Meena? We had a student called as Meenakshi. But no. Loud the fact. Yeah. So, what I loved was your comments. I knew what was it, no? So you all said brownie, chocolate, and everything. So that made me literally like laugh. Yes. Meena and Han observed an animal in their garden. So Hari, okay, this is some different person. Hari called it an insect, while Meena said it was earthworm. Okay, it is not Han. Okay, it is Hari. That's why. That's what I was feeling. One is Indian name, and another one is some a foreign name. How it is possible? It is Meena and Hari. So Meena called the organism as earthworm. Hari called this particular organism as an insect. Okay, so choose the correct or choose the character from the O-wing which confirms that it is an insect. Simple student, simple question. B. Simple student, simple question it is. Insect. Insect belongs to which phylum? If you know that, you will be able to answer the question. Hari is purely Indian. Yeah, I thought it is Han. Han. Okay, it is Hari. Okay, all the best, Krishna Vini. All the best, all the best. So let me call the student's name, whoever have given the right answer. Satyart, Gautam, Deepti, Divyanshi, Shlok, Vandana, Aisha, and Sanket Pal, Aryaman. So answer is going to be the body is having the jointed legs. Jointed legs is the characteristic feature of the phylum Arthropoda, and phylum Arthropoda has got different classes. The one biggest class that you're able to see under the Arthropoda is Insecta. Okay, so you know the answer. Next question. Yes. Whale is kept in the class. So whale is kept in which among the following class of the organism? Pisces, mammal, apes, amphibians. Answer the question. You were saying B as right answer. I was not able to see your comment, no? Sabira. Yes. Answer, students, whale. Easy question. Yes. Everyone is answering the question because whale is the biggest mammal. I shouldn't have given this question. Which of the following classes without? Okay. Epidermal scale. Without epidermal scale. Yes. Which of the following classes without epidermal scale? Epidermal scale is nothing but a scale that is found in the skin, right? Answer the question quickly. Answer, students, quite controversial question, right? What is the answer for the question? Which of the following class does not have scales. Okay. Something, students. Let me tell you something. Are you able to see any scales in amphibians? Are you able to see scales in amphibians? If yes, tell me which amphibians have got epidermal scales. Please tell me. Please tell me. Which organisms has epidermal scales? Frog. Do you know what is scale first of all? Crocodile is not amphibians. Students, answer is amphibians. We are able to see scales in the organisms like pangolin, right? Which belongs to the mammal. Fish has got cycloid, placoid scales, epidermal scales even fish is going to have. Apes, in the case of apes, they have got, epidermal, I mean, in the case of birds, if you see, their limbs, some of the birds in their limbs, you are able to see scales, whereas in the case of frog, I can say in the case of amphibians, we are not able to see any scales. So, only a few of you gave the right answer. That is, I can say Nagarju had given the right answer. I guess only him. Rest all had given wrong answer. Yeah. Next question. Birds. Birds are endothermal, warm-blooded, both A and B, ectothermal. What happened, Chaturya? You have not seen pangolin. Got wrong. Epidermal scale is nothing but the skin is nothing but epidermal, and scale is nothing but the dry skin. Some of the organisms will be having dry skin, some of the organisms will be having real scales. So both of them can be referred as epidermal scale. The question was epidermal scale was not is not found in, right? That was the question, right? Yeah, without epidermal scale, correct. Yes. Now answer the question. Birds are endothermal, warm-blooded, both A and B, ectothermal. Students, I know even if you do not know the meaning of ectothermal, endothermal, the most probable question, the most probable answer is going to be both A and B. That's how you gave the answer. That's why I'm able to see all of you giving the right answer. Yes. So, Krish, Divyanshi, Chaturya, Komal, Shivam, students like the video, Aisha, Krishnaveni, basically everyone have given the right answer. That is, see, endothermal is nothing but warm-blooded only. So the organisms which are able to show endothermal or warm-blooded nature, they are able to regulate their body temperature. Okay, yeah. Next question. Flowering plants are included under. Flowering plants are included under cryptogams, phanerogams, bryophytes, pteridophytes. Students, keep liking the video as well. What is ectothermal? Ecto means outside. That is, these organisms which are ectothermal, they are cold-blooded animals. They are not able to regulate their body temperature based upon the surrounding environment. They will be changing their body temperature. Okay, ecto, external. External temperature is going to show the effect on the organisms that are ectothermal. They are, right? Yes, flowering plants. What are flowering plants? Yes. Everyone gave the answer. Shivam, Krish, Aisha, Satyarth, Madhav, Sanket, Deepti, Krish, Jesse, Sanjay, Divyanshi. So answer is going to be bryophytes, don't produce flowers, ma'am. Cryptogams, hidden sex organs, ma'am. Phanerogams are having gymnosperms as well as angiosperm. Angiosperms are flowering plants. So that's why answer is going to be phanerogamy. Next question. Which of the following has embryo, they have embryo, but they lack vascular tissue. Answer. Answer quickly. B for ball. Okay, so which of the following has the embryo but lacks vascular tissue? Embryo is present because there are some of the plant in which even embryo is also not present. Pata nahi ma'am, sorry. A C. Okay, let me call your name, whoever have given the right answer for today. I mean for this particular question. That is, I myself getting confused by seeing your answers. Like I'm like, what? How students aren't able to give the answer for this question? Krish, Krish, Chaturya, Archana, completed. Okay, Divyanshi, and no, that's it. Madhav have given the right answer. That is students. Bryophytes. In the case of bryophytes, we are able to see embryo, but they won't be having vascular tissue. In the case of thallophyta, we are not able to see embryo as well. Forget about vascular tissue. Even embryo is also not seen in the case of thallophyta. Whereas pteridophytes, they will be having both. Okay, pteridophytes, gymnosperms, angiosperms, they are vascular cryptogams, so they have got vascular tissue. Next question. Okay. Did I say vascular cryptogams? Vascular cryptogams are only pteridophytes. Gymnosperm, angiosperms are phanerogams. Three kingdom system classification was proposed by three kingdom system, two kingdom system, two, three, four, five, six, up till six kingdom system classification. Everyone should be knowing who had given this system of classification. I know you might also have to by heart, but my dear students know the answer. They gave answer already. Chota bhai kaun si class mein hai? 8th standard. I mean, I just freeze. I was like, wait, he was 7th, 8th, 9th, 8th standard. Okay. So let me call the student's name, whoever have given the right answer for the question. Krish, Vandana, Muskan, Chaturya, Sai, Smaran, so Arnav. So answer is students B. So let's quickly write. Linnaeus had given not one system of classification. Arnav, not one. Ha. Definitely, I can repeat. Nandini. Two kingdom system classification is being given by Linnaeus. Copland had given three kingdom system classification. Haeckel had given four kingdom system classification. And Whittaker had given five kingdom system classification. Karl Woese had given six kingdom system classification. Okay, take down, write down. Yes. Linnaeus, Haeckel. Wait. Lamarck? Why are you adding Lamarck? Lamarck comes in evolution. Okay, yeah. So according to NCERT textbook, I'm following. According to NCERT textbook, Haeckel is the one who had given four kingdom system classification. Please make corrections, students. Please make the corrections. Four is. Oh, sorry. I'm so sorry. I did a mistake. Sorry. Three kingdom system. I mean, sorry. Four. This is three. Yeah. Three kingdom system classification is being given by Haeckel. Four is by Copland. Yeah, sorry. Lamarck nahi hai. Lamarck comes under evolution. Yeah, Lamarckism, use, disuse theory, inheritance of acquired characters. Remember about Lamarck. Next question. Classification. Okay, this is the last question for today, students. Classification reflecting evolutionary interrelationships of the organism is called as phylogenetic classification, artificial classification, natural classification, numerical classification. Yeah. No. I just messed up here. It is not I have written a Copeland is 4, Haeckel is 3. Sorry, I'm so sorry for that. Answer is Haeckel only. Okay, yeah. Here now, whenever you are able to see evolutionary relationship, you should be able to go always and always for yes, Satyarth, Himanshi, Krish, Chaturya, Anirudh, Madhav, Sanket, Shivam, Divyanshi. Basically, all of you have given the right answer, phylogenetic. Okay, so phylogenetic classification is nothing but classification based upon the evolutionary study. Phylogenetic, phylogeny means all about evolution, right students? So like the video first of all, and students, tomorrow and day after tomorrow I have kept free special class in the foundation and NTSC category. Okay, at 4 p.m. at 4 p.m. there is a free special class in foundation and NTSC category. So ask me what is the class. Tomorrow we will be discussing the IOQJS most asked IOQJS question, which will be having INJSO as well as NSCJS, and this is going to happen tomorrow, 27th. You know what I have kept on 28th. Again, the time is 4 p.m. We will be discussing UPSC prelims biology question from the general science. How is the idea, students? Huh? Anyone want to crack UPSC in future? Yeah? Mammals are not arised from reptiles. Mammals are arised from the bird. The connecting link from the mammals, I mean from the apes to, that is from the birds to mammals, is platypus, duck-billed platypus. That is the connecting link. Okay. Yeah. I hope you are excited for this particular class at least, because this is the first time in foundation and NTSC category someone is teaching for UPSC exam, UPSC foundation. Okay, for the class 9, 10, 10 students. Okay. Yes. हाँ, hi Vijay. Ma'am, kya mujhe NTSC stage 2 ke liye fir se apply karna pad? No. See, once you had already applied for the NTSC stage 1, you shouldn't be applying for the stage 2. Okay, you should be simply waiting for the result. Hi Vijaya, namaste. Yes. So NTSC stage 2 questions we will be discussing in the upcoming classes. You can see some of the classes that is going to happen tomorrow, day after tomorrow and everything, right? So students, tomorrow at 5:30 p.m. most easy questions of NTSC stage 2 is going to happen in this particular channel only. Okay, so don't worry about the stage 2 exam. And students, ma'am, I will crack UPSC. So students, you are excited then. Tomorrow students join at 4 p.m. in an academy foundation foundation NTSC Olympiad category, 4 p.m. UPSC prelims questions, general science, right? No, I'm not ignoring anyone, Om Siku. So that's all for today. And if you haven't taken the subscription yet, take the subscription as soon as possible while joining the any of the free special classes, or maybe if you want to take the subscription, you can use my code VRLIVE. Okay, so while joining the class in all the free special class, you can use the code VRLIVE without any gap, right? Yes. So while taking the subscription, it's important to go for either 1 year or 2 year subscription, because in this 1 or 2 year subscription, you will be able to cover the whole syllabus of NTSC, IOQJS, CBSE 9, CBSE 10th, including NEET and JEE. So that's why it is important to go for either 1 year or 2 year, because in 1 month, 3 months, we are not able to complete anything. Okay. So also, if you want to take the subscription of 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, that is only we will be teaching over there only for final exams of class 9th and 10th standard, you can take the subscription of those. And while taking the subscription, again use the code VRLIVE. So that's all for today. Like the video, share the video, and you know the code for free classes, special classes, test series, even for the subscription, for everything you can use the code VRLIVE, right? So bye bye.